just days after a man took a hostage at Gateway Center, police negotiators are revealing the tactics they used to get him to release that victim and peacefully surrender. It was a tense 6 hours as those officers stayed in contact with the suspect. Channel 11's Vince Sims is live at police headquarters after talking with the negotiators who were at the center of it all. Vince.
Well, because their jobs are so important in what they have to do, we wanted to know what type of tactics they actually use after Friday's ordeal downtown. Well, today I got a chance to get an inside look at what they go through.
Anything you might say, even though you believe it's insignificant or you might be helping, might be something that inflames the situation and could ultimately cause someone to take someone's life.
Lieutenant Jason Lando is a member of the Pittsburgh Police Tactical Negotiations Team. He was working when police say Klein Thaxton held a man hostage inside 3 Gateway Center for several hours.
Clearly, we're always very concerned about the hostage, but when we do negotiations, we have to make it all about the hostage taker or the person in crisis.
Today I had a chance to ask them about their extensive training and how they do their job. Some of the training involves psychology and dealing with people through the FBI. They go through quarterly updates and even do role playing.
We will do what we call back to backs, and we'll sit with our backs to each other. One person will be the role player, one person will be the negotiator.
During this ordeal, we saw negotiators bring in Thaxton's mom and his ex-girlfriend. I'm told they consider very carefully what others to bring in as to make sure the situation doesn't get worse. The people they choose are instructed on what message they want to get across to the hostage taker. Officials say this isn't like TV. They don't meet demands, they meet needs. They achieve outcomes like Friday by making a connection and listening to the suspect.
We do more listening than we do talking, right? So we do a lot of listening. We call it active listening. That's the foundation of what we do.
Now, that was just a small portion of the group that was actually working on Friday. There are actually 24 active members on the tactical negotiations team. I asked one of them exactly why he decided to be a part of this team, and he said because he thought he could make a difference. Reporting live from police headquarters, Vince Sims, Channel 11 News.
There's no 100% right or wrong thing to say, but obviously you have to be very cognizant of anything you say that might set the individual off. You know, our whole goal is to bring the situation down, calm the person down.
We do a lot of listening, right? We try to develop some empathy with the subject. So hopefully we hope that leads to some type of rapport, where we make a connection on some level with the person, because again, it's just a person-to-person conversation.
We're normally called out alongside the SWAT team on every mission they go on, but I believe, as Matt alluded to earlier, a true hostage situation like this is very few and far between.